Finally, I heard that Meshtastic supports TDEC and I thought it was time to do what I want to do. As you know, Meshtastic enables decentralized, off-grid communication based on LoRa. Therefore, by building your own network, you can do many things within it, such as controlling sensors, as well as sending and receiving messages. First, after bringing the TDEC device, you can swipe the screen to move to the next screen or use the trackball. Unfortunately, TDEC device does not include the GPS module, so there's no need for a GPS-related screen for now. Today, I will look at the most common use case. Let me send a message from TDEC to iPhone. Okay, it's sending. Did you get it? I got a message on my iPhone. It says hello and TDEC says deliver to broadcast. This time, let's send a message from iPhone as well. There's no problem sending or receiving messages. This is all sent in broadcast format, so anyone on the same channel could receive this message. This time, instead of a broadcast message, I will send a direct message to a specific user. You can change the message type by using the trackball or swiping the screen. Sending. On iPhone, you can check these messages in direct messages. Here you are. You can see my message from TDEC. As expected, it was sent well. I will also send a direct message from my iPhone to TDEC. This is to share your current location and request location information from the other party. The message was sent without any hassle. It works great. Let's talk about my configuration. First, I have my iPhone here. Since iPhone does not have a LoRa module, we must connect a module capable of LoRa communication. Here, I use a T-Beam device, so my iPhone connects to T-Beam through Bluetooth. One problem, but it's not a problem, is that since it's connected via Bluetooth, we need to power it separately. Because I didn't like this way, so in my previous projects, I use UART serial communication by connecting the mobile and the device with the cable. However, since even UART serial communication is not possible on iPhone, Bluetooth is only way to communicate with external devices. Anyway, back to the main topic, I installed Meshtastic's firmware to T-Beam and TDEC. This makes everything very simple to use. After installing like this, you just need to configure a few things and you are ready to use it. You can configure off-grid communication based on LoRa very easily. Now you can send and receive messages between the two devices. Of course, more than two devices. Messages can be sent by broadcasting or only to a specific device. Now let's take a look at the firmware installation. Here are the two devices I'll be using. The one on the left is T-Beam and the one on the right is TDEC. Both of the devices are officially supported by Meshtastic, so installing firmware is very easy. The easiest and recommended way is to use this ESP32 web installer. This works fine in Chrome browser, so try it if you have any issue on your browser. In the case of T-Beam, installation has started, but in the case of TDEC, it's still being prepared for installation and cannot proceed to the next step. I tried changing TDEC to download mode, but there seems to be something wrong in my case and it's stuck. So in the end, I tried downloading and installing the firmware file directly. You can download the firmware binary file from this page for your device. If you download and unzip this, you will see these files. You can check all device firmwares supported by the web installer. Let's open a terminal and install the firmware directory from the command line interface to the device. You must have Python and ESP tool installed before trying this way. If the ESP IDF environment is already established, you are good to go. Looking at the connected serial port, it seems that the device is not properly connected yet. Let me reconnect the TDEC. I'm checking the port again. Now I can see the USB modem item. Great. Then let's install it through the device install shell script file. Append the connected port and also specify the firmware file to install. And finally, flashing begins. After cleaning all of the flash, you will see the writing start. This way, I was able to install firmware on the TDAC. It will automatically reboot after installation. You can see unset on the top left of the screen. This means that the region has not been set yet. All devices you will use must have the same regional settings, so let's fix this first. You can easily set up your device through the client web page. Since it's connected via serial, and select number 0. Here, you can change the name of your device. Let's just change LoRa's regional settings. In the config menu, select LoRa. You will see the regional item. Here, you can select your region. I choose US. If you click the save icon in the top right, it will be saved and the device will automatically reboot. Please wait a moment. Meshtastic starts and you can see that it's set to US. This completes the TDAC setup. Now I'll show you the configuration by connecting the T-Beam to my iPhone. After running the app, you should see your T-Beam device in available radios. If you do not see it, please try restarting T-Beam. I will select my device A2C0 and connect. The pairing code is 123456. When recording the screen on iPhone, the password, password input is not visible. Anyway, it's connected. If you look at the node, you can see nearby LoRa devices. It seems like my T-Beam has already recognized the TDAC. Here, you can see available information on my device. You can see battery information in the device metrics log. In node map, you can see the movement of this device on the map. You can check GPS information in position log. In the settings menu, you can see the same menus that can be set on the client web page. Here, you can change the device name. You can set your region in LoRa settings. This was already set to US by default, so there was nothing to modify. Because US was the default, I think it was able to recognize the TDAC right next to me. This completes the settings for basic communication. Off-grid network based on LoRa is very interesting. Today's video covers only basic settings and simple sending messages. Both devices are typically end devices that act as clients. In addition to this role, there is also a repeater to extend a longer distance, and it is also possible to set up a node just for sensor controller. There seems to be a lot we can do with Meshtastic. I think I need to find a fun project I can do using this. If you have any good ideas, please leave a comment. I will try it. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.